From one species that can effectively walk out of the water, to another which is known as the fish from hell. Here are 9 fish that can hunt land animals. Before we begin, be sure to subscribe to They Will Kill You. Hit the like button and request any topics you'd like to learn about in the comments section below. Number 9, Mudskipper. Mudskippers are found in temperate, subtropical and tropical regions, including the Atlantic coast of Africa and the Indo-Pacific. Like the name would suggest, this fish has several fascinating adaptations which enable it to travel on land as well as in the water. They're able to walk or skip on land by using their pectoral and pelvic fins. On land, they survive by breathing through their skin, throat, and the mucous lining of their mouth. This is called cutaneous air breathing, and it's similar to the way amphibians breathe on land. However, this is only possible when mudskippers are moist, which is why they tend to be restricted to humid habitats. They're able to regulate their body temperatures by digging deep burrows in soft sediments, which also protect them from predators during high tide. On land, mudskippers perform a wide variety of activities. These include feeding, courting potential partners, as well as establishing and defending territories. Their diets include snails, insects, small crabs, and even other mudskippers. Number 8, Tiger Shark. Up until recently, the consensus was that tiger sharks only feed on marine animals and water birds. Then, a researcher from Dauphin Island Sea Lab named Marcus Dryman made an interesting discovery in 2009. After he caught a tiger shark off the coast of Alabama, Dryman noticed that the shark had coughed up feathers. Interestingly enough, these feathers didn't belong to a water bird. This led Dryman to suspect that tiger sharks might be supplementing their diets with other types of birds. A study followed in which the stomachs of over 50 tiger sharks were dissected. The contents of about half of the fish's stomachs revealed beaks, feathers, and feet from terrestrial birds like meadowlarks, woodpeckers, and tanagers. The theory is that as they migrate, some birds lose their way. They're thus forced to keep flying until they become exhausted, which brings them closer and closer to the surface where the tiger sharks are waiting to snap them in their jaws. Number 7, Wells Catfish. Wells Catfish is, by all accounts, a true river monster. In 2009, a large catfish almost drowned a Hungarian fisherman. He had attempted to grab the fish in a hold, but soon regretted the decision. The fisherman barely escaped with his life after the fish dragged him underwater by his right leg. Wells catfish can potentially weigh over 660 pounds while measuring up to 16 feet. That's significantly larger than any human being. Even though reports of such giants have become a rarity in recent years, an interesting tendency has been observed in medium-sized catfish from the Tarn River in Albi, France. They've reportedly developed an ability to grab pigeons from the riverbank. It's believed that the larger catfish have taken to hunting in the river depths, forcing the smaller catfish to search for other sources of food. It's also suspected that the larger specimens can't swim the shallow waters to get to the riverbank. After the catfish grab the pigeons, they consume them in the water. Based on observation, they have a kill rate of 28%. This may seem low, but it's actually quite impressive for a fish hunting an animal that can essentially fly away when threatened. Number 6, African tiger fish. This fish genus, native to the African continent, is commonly referred to as tiger fish. The scientific name for the genus is Hydrocynus, and it consists of 5 species, which are all typically piscivorous, meaning they feed on other fish. Hydrocynus vitatus, however, has become recorded displaying a rather unique adaptation. It's the only freshwater fish species proven to prey on birds in flight. Its main target consists of low-flying barn swallows. A sleek body that measures over 3 feet in length and sharp fang-like teeth enable tiger fish to quickly jump out of the water and grab birds as they fly past. Different hunting strategies have also been observed. One is to hide just beneath the surface and to ambush the bird in flight, while another involves chasing the bird from the surface and then leaping to grab it. The first time this phenomenon was observed, it happened so fast that the team responsible for recording it barely had time to realize what happened. Number 5. Eel catfish. Researchers speculate that the eel catfish uses the same method to hunt on land that was used by the first vertebrates to venture out of the water around 420 million years ago. To catch insects on land, the eel catfish will arch its specialized spine to rise above its prey, which usually consists of various insects. Then, the eel descends on it, trapping its prey against the ground and bending its mouth around it. Eel catfish jaw muscles are hypertrophic, meaning that the cells in the tissue are larger, which increases bite strength. In the water, the eel catfish employs a different hunting technique. It expands its mouth cavity, pulling in extra water and sucking up prey. On land, this hunting technique wouldn't work because air is around 800 times less dense than water. Number 4. Silver arowana. The silver arowana is native to South America, and some species are known to reach almost 4 feet in length. In its native waters, the silver arowana is known as the monkey fish for its ability to capture prey by jumping out of the water. They typically swim near the surface while looking out for potential prey on tree branches. The targets of its jumping attacks may include snakes, insects, bats, or birds. Once it's found a suitable victim, the fish unleashes its incredibly swift attack with a staggering jump that can reach over 6 feet above the water surface. Despite this impressive hunting technique, the silver arowana usually uses its drawbridge-like mouth to eat animals floating on the surface, like crustaceans or smaller fish. Number 3. Rainbow trout. This colorful fish is known to fight back when caught and for its ability to jump high above the water when hunting prey. This predator will eat nearly anything it captures with a varied diet, including insects, smaller fish, and even some small land animals. The rainbow trout usually hunts for land animals during their breeding season, when the prey is abundant. In 2013, a researcher discovered a rainbow trout with the remains of 20 shrews in its stomach. This furthered understanding of how apt the fish is at tackling land prey. Wildlife experts believe that the trout grabs these creatures whenever they venture close to the riverbank. Number 2. Archer fish. Much like the name implies, this freshwater fish takes down prey using a ranged attack. After the archer fish selects its target, which usually consists of insects hanging from tree branches, it contracts its gills to shoot a water stream from its mouth. The stream is shaped by the fish's mouthparts to travel faster at the rear than at the front, forming a type of blob that impacts the target. From around 3 to nearly 7 feet, they're remarkably accurate shots. However, even if they miss the target, the persistent archer fish will take multiple shots. What's even more remarkable is that the archer fish will develop its skill through social learning. This means that they can observe how one member of the school uses the shooting technique to later adapt or modify their angles and target distances. Younger fish are initially inaccurate, so by hunting in small schools, they develop their shooting through observation and experience. It has recently emerged that archer fish also use jets to hunt underwater prey. Experts don't know which hunting technique developed first, whether it was the aerial or underwater one. According to one theory, they evolved in parallel, complementing each other the more they were used by the archer fish. Number 1. Snakehead fish. Snakeheads are elongated fish with large mouths, sharp, shiny teeth, and long dorsal fins. There are 40 snakehead species belonging to two main types, the Parachana, native to Africa, and the Chana in Asia. Since these freshwater fish breathe air through their gills, they're able to migrate short distances on land by wriggling with their bodies and fins. Snakeheads can travel almost 1/4 of a mile on land, where they can survive for up to 4 days. That's bad news for animals on the shorelines or riverbanks, as some snakehead species, like the northern snakehead, can grow to be over 3 feet. National Geographic has described the snakehead as Fishzilla. For more than 100 years, humans have been introducing snakeheads to non-indigenous waters where they become invasive and cause ecological damage. The lack of natural predators in these waters means that snakeheads often reach apex status. They also tend to spread rapidly. By the age of 2 or 3, the snakehead has already reached sexual maturity, and a single female may release up to 150,000 eggs every 2 years. After it was introduced, either intentionally or ignorantly, in North American waters, the aggressive snakehead earned the reputation of Frankenfish, Monsterfish, or the Fish from Hell. Thanks for watching. Which fish do you think is the most apt at hunting land animals? Let us know in the comments section below.